Hi, thank you for joining Pioneer. My name is Aaron Pence. I'm from the Norman Central Library. I appreciate you spending a few minutes with me today. Our moon is ready to rise through the night sky. Let's get it moving. You get to watch a lot of troubleshooting today, because this animation won't work over and over and over until finally it does. It's fun. I bet you are expecting me to tell you about X and Y again so that we can move our moon, but I'm not gonna. This time, we don't actually want to use X and Y to move our moon. In central Oklahoma, the moon rises in the east and heads southward until it's all the way up. If we were watching Moonrise, we'd be looking east, so the moon would be heading up and a little to the right. So we don't want our moon to go straight up. We want it to go up and a little right. We could combine change X and Y blocks to do that, but there's a better tool in Scratch for when the directions are a little mixed up. It's the Move 10 Steps block. The Move 10 Steps block works together with the Point and Direction block to get a sprite turned a certain way and then to have the sprite go in that direction. We will use Point and Direction to get the moon heading the right way, just a little to the right of straight up, then move 10 steps to move it that way. So first, click on Code, and let's get a yellow event block when green flag clicked to start our script. Then we'll go to the blue motion blocks. Now, grab a point in direction 90 block, snap it in, and grab a move 10 steps block and snap it in. We don't want the moon to go in direction 90. That's straight to the right. Take a look. So click the little 90 bubble. This little wheel comes up. Get your moon pointed in the right direction by clicking and dragging on this arrow. I think I'll use 15 degrees. That's just a little to the right of straight up. Click your green flag. Well, and click it again, and again, and again, and again, and again. Okay, so two things happened. First, it didn't go on its own. We had to keep clicking the flag to get it high enough in the sky. Second, the moon flopped over on its side. These are both easy problems to fix. First, we just need a forever loop from the orange control blocks to get it to move on its own. Grab one and drag it around the two blue blocks in your script, like so. Second, we need to fix the rotation style of the sprite. We don't want our moon to spin around as we assign its orbital direction. In fact, we don't want it to spin around at all. Go to the blue motion blocks and find a set rotation style block. Drag that into the forever loop and change the rotation style to don't rotate. I'm gonna move the moon. You will probably watch me adjust the position of this sprite with my mouse a lot. Just click and drag on the moon to move it somewhere else. Now click your green flag. Hey, all right, that's closer. It's still too fast. And it looks weird when it gets to the top and just sort of slides along there, but we're making progress. Let's fix these two things. Slowing it down is easy. If moving 10 steps is too fast, then we should make it take fewer steps. I think I'll try one step instead and see how I feel about it. Click in this 10 bubble of the move 10 steps block and change it to a 1. Try it now. Better, better. Now we need to fix the top sliding bit. I think what I want is for the moon to go back for another moonrise when it gets too high up. I want it to go back to the bottom and then come back up a little bit later. But how do we know when the moon gets too high up? This is a cool trick that I use in Scratch all the time. We can measure the X and Y position of sprites and then make Scratch do something to them if the X or Y position gets past a certain line. It's great. Click the green flag and watch the Y position of our moon here, right here. See how it goes up and up and up? It goes up and up and up until it hits 235. See it right here? If we move it back down, it goes up and up and up until it hits 235. That tells me that 235 in the Y coordinate is where we'd like something to happen. Now, we're gonna use an if block inside our forever loop to keep checking for the Y position of the moon. And if it gets up to 235, then we'll just move it back to the start. We'll also make it wait for a few seconds when that happens, so it's not just rising and rising and rising. Go to the orange control blocks and grab an if block. Drop it on the side over here. Go to the green operators blocks and grab this equals 50 block. Drop it inside the hexagon of your if block. Go to the blue motion blocks, scroll down a little, and grab a Y position bubble. Drop that in the blank bubble of your equal to block. Also, change this number 50 to read 235. We've got the if part built now, if Y position equals 235. So now we need to build the then part. Click and drag on the moon to get it in a good position near the bottom. I think this will work. Then go to the blue motion blocks and grab a go to XY block. Snap that inside the mouth of the if. Last, go to the orange control blocks and grab a wait 1 seconds block. Snap that inside the mouth of the if after the go to XY block and change the number of seconds to 10. Now that you've built that, we should put the if inside the forever loop. After the move 1 steps block, if you grab the if block right here, move it under move 1 steps and let go, snaps right into place. Great. Click the green flag. Let's see how it does. It's moving up. Great. Looks good. What you should see is when the moon gets to the top, it disappears. Watch carefully right here. Oh, it did. And it moved down to the bottom, just like we asked. It seems to be waiting. Let's see if it picks back up here in just a second. Great. Looks good. Last thing. You see how the moon is in front of the ground? That's wrong. If the moon does that where you live, you need to call NASA or Spaceman Spiff or somebody. We can fix it easily. We just need the ground to be in front of the moon. Click on the ground sprite here in the bottom right. Go to the yellow events blocks and grab a when green flag clicked. Drag it over here. Then go to the purple looks blocks, scroll down, and grab a go to front layer block. Snap that in. Now, I think we're ready. Click your green flag. Did you see how the moon disappeared behind the ground? What you should see is the moon gets to the top. It will disappear when it gets up high enough, when Y equals 235. It's waiting for 10 seconds behind the ground, and then you should see it come up over the horizon. Super cool. I think that looks so cool. Next time, we'll make lots of stars for our sky the easy way. Thanks a lot. See you soon.